And here we go.
Algebra 2, lesson 7-9. Today's date is the 16th of March.
16/3/2023. Tomorrow is St. Patrick's Day. Thank you for reminding me. Wear green tomorrow.
What if I want green?
Then you get pinched.
Pinched tomorrow.
There.
Not to tomorrow.
All right, so let me remind you of the zero product property. Let's say I have something times something else, but I know the answer is zero. What do you know about A and B? What?
Zero.
Like if I say A is equal to zero, doesn't that make the answer zero?
Yeah.
Do you know what else would make the answer zero? B equals zero. That would make the answer zero. These are both solutions to this. So what if I make it harder? Well, if it's negative one, it could be like, so you have to be careful. I'm gonna erase this in a sec, but if you're like A times B is equal to negative one, is that what you're saying?
No.
No. Okay. I'll solve it. Let's move on to example one. What if I changed A into this linear factor of x plus 3? And what if I change B into another factor? We'll make it a linear factor, 2x plus 8. And I set this equal to 0. What do we know about x plus 3? What is a potential answer? We know that A could be zero, so that part could be zero, which means that part could also be zero. X plus 3 being set to zero is one of the two answers. And then we'll eventually get negative 3. So, can you predict what the answer is going to be over here? Very good. A lot of people are tricked and be like, oh, you just switched the answer there. That's a 3, so the answer is negative 3, and you're right. So people are like, oh, you just take this answer, you get negative 8. You're wrong, because you have to kind of think about the whole entire process. Yeah, because you have a 2x plus 8, not just an x plus 8. So here are the two different problems. Let me go ahead and show you. There's two different problems here. Okay. This one problem on the left-hand side, we're just going to subtract 3, and x is equal to negative 3, which again is the opposite of this. It was a positive 3, now it's a negative 3. Easy. Nod our heads. That makes sense.
Yeah.
No? Welcome, whoever just joined Zoom. We cannot see you because we're presenting. Hopefully you're okay. We're doing lesson 7-9. All right, in this second side of the problem, we need to solve for x, which means we're first going to get rid of that plus 8. We're going to subtract 8 on both sides, meaning that we have a 2x is equal to negative 8. And we're not done. Finally, Josue, I will divide by 2 on both sides of the equal sign, and x will be equal to Josue.
Negative 4.
Very good. So your two answers here would be negative 4 and negative 3. That is a basic type of example. Sometimes I will be nice, and I will give you it factored. Sometimes I'll be me. So I want to play the what if game. He's copying me, so making this play the
service.
What if I change the problem? What if there was, I don't know, a 7 right there? How would that have changed the problem? What if I put this 7? Right here.
Distribute and then.
Wouldn't it be the same thing? Because then it would be 7x and then you divide it by at the end and then it would be the same as.
Yeah, so check this out, guys. Watch this. If I were to distribute, I would have 7 times x plus 3. Distribute, and I get 7x plus 21, which is still equal to 0. I would subtract 21. and I'd get 7x is equal to negative 21. I would divide by 7, divide by 7. I'd get x is equal to negative 3. And oh, look, you and you
are the same. It doesn't. As Jose was saying over here,
putting just a number out front, this doesn't change the problem. So I'll say numbers with no variables, just ignore. They do not change your answer. This will typically be a GCF. So let's see another example. This is like, should we just jump up to advanced level and then we can start?
Wait.
I don't want you to cry, so let's do intermediate. And I'll also wait because Ashley's coming away, which means I'll drink some water. I'll drink some water like this. Yeah, totally. Thank you.
Oh, are you going to get a drink of water?
Yeah, I'm going to get a drink
of
water. Yeah. Can I go get a drink of water?
No.
Can I get a drink of water when Solomon gets back?
Yep.
Jason, no.
Yeah.
While we're waiting, can I answer your question from last period?
Yes.
I think we should kill him and his family.
Whoa!
What?
Yeah, taking out of context, that sounds really bad, but that's a little bit more extreme than I would do. I think Solomon decided just to cut off their hands.
Well, we might.
Because when you cut off their hands as a goldsmith, then they can't really work anymore.
30% gold. 30,
who did?
We can just take all of his earnings from his business too.
Or make him go bankrupt.
Yeah.
Move his entire life. Starve his children.
No, if he's
or frame him so his wife leaves and takes the kids. So he's left with nothing.
All right. Were you saying that problem out of context and making it super dramatic because you thought it would be cool, or would you actually do that?
Would I actually what?
Would you actually do that?
Me personally, no. But I would have someone else do it.
Okay.
Like, I'm not going to actually go there and, like, kill him and his family. I can't do that personally, but, like, someone else could.
Yeah, okay.
That I know really personally, I could just hire someone. And I could print. Here's also what else I can do. I can make it look like an accident, like he was just broken into.
No, you can't do that. You have to make an example out of it. All right, and example number 2. This is going to be our intermediate example, and then example number 3 will be our advanced example. And let me make sure that I have everything. Oh, sometimes that happens. All right, I have to be careful here. Let's go ahead and do this problem. I need to really quickly write down some work. What's this going to be? Excellent. There's my problem that I just made up for nothing. Here's your problem. I want to do 24x to the power. Do I ever do higher powers? No, I don't go anything higher than that. 24x squared plus 28x plus 8. And that is equal to 0.
Damn, that's crazy.
That is a crazy problem. Just want to check my math.
Wait, so
excuse me.
Wouldn't we use the I thing over here?
Wait, never mind. Sometimes you might have to use I. Let me look at the back of your homework. Nope. I only usually comes out from square rooting negatives, but these you don't really square root, right? You just set them equal to 0 and then do algebra. It's really hard to get a square root of a negative if you never take a square root. All right. Factor. Show me how to factor. Remind me how to factor. First step is always 2, or the zeroth step is always 2. GCF. I can divide each of these by what number? I think 4 is the base one. Yes, let's do 4. If I divide them all by 4, 4,
wait,
you divide out these. You can do 2, but then I think you go even more. I think 4 is the biggest, is the greatest common factor. All right.
Whoa.
This is fun.
All right, Ripley, what do I put inside the parentheses here?
Six.
Good. Yes, give me the next one.
The only one I don't know.
You don't know 28 divided by 4? I'll give you a hint. It's between 6 and 8.
Wait, what?
Oh my god! Five!
Yep, 7. Yep, good. We'll give it to Carlos. Positivo with negativo. And that's still being set equal to 0. From here, that 4 is going to stay there basically forever. On the side, over here on the right, I'm going to do a normal ninja star, advanced ninja star. What should I do?
Ninja star.
Why do I do an advanced ninja star instead of a normal ninja star?
I know, ninja star 2 6.
Because of what about the 6, Ashley? Yeah, I mean, kind of. I mean, just the mere fact that there is a 6. Usually, we don't have a number here that we do a normal ninja star. Anything other than nothing, like 6 or 7, then it's advanced ninja star. Yep. All right, let's go ahead and set this thing up. I'm gonna add to, we're gonna add to 7. We're gonna multiply, let's see how many people remember how to set up the advanced ninja star. This is the most common mistake I've seen this year.
I know. Isn't that gonna be like 12?
It is 12, how'd you get 12, Yessie?
6.
Yeah, first and last number come up here, they multiply together to get 12. All right, Anatoly, what goes here and here? 3 times 4 is 12, and 3 plus 4 is 7. Oh, great. He solved it for us. All right, and then from there, what do I do with this thing, Jose?
You divide.
Divide top and bottom by?
3.
Divide by 3, so our new fraction is going to turn into?
2 over 1.
2x over 1, and what about? Who have I not called? Oh, Hades over there. She has. No, let's take a break so that Hades can catch up, and then we'll ask her the question.
Oh my god.
Is Ashley the only one with a water bottle here?
It's empty. I forgot.
I need to drink more water.
I drink coffee.
Especially people that are working out. Like, water is super important when you're working out. All right, Amy, you ready?
Maybe.
How do we reduce this? You think of this as a fraction, the fraction 6 over 4. We divide the top and bottom by 2, and we get what, Haiti? You got this. 6x divided by 2.
3x.
Okay, let her answer. Over.
Over
2. There it is. And then we're going to write out our factored form. So again, this 4 has not gone anywhere. It's still 4. We do have 2 linear pairs in here. We have a 2x minus 1. You guys remember the word linear? What does that mean again?
Why is that 2x minus 1?
Yeah.
Minus 1.
Because I want to get some extra credit. I don't know how many people got it.
Yeah, that's
enough. Now he's paying attention. I'll give you guys another 10 seconds to find the mistake. Raise your hand if you think you got it.
Oh, I got it. Woo!
Oh, and people's hands raised. I'm going to randomly select on Ashley.
It's supposed to be 2x plus 1.
Good. All right. Anyone that thinks that they got that, pull your extra credit tracker. I'll come by and add the extra credit in a sec. The next one should be 3x plus 2. I'm not going to give any more extra credit than that. And I'm still not done. I factored it. That is just the first step. And now I use the zero product property. To do what with a quiet raise? Oh, wait, there's a Zoom kid in there. Chloe, you're there, right? Chloe, what do we do from here? This thing's being set equal to 0.
She
Can you give me like 5 seconds to think?
That's five.
Can I popcorn it?
Yeah, popcorn it.
I thought you can someone else just answer? I forgot how to do these.
Josue hasn't been called on yet today. Josue, what do we do now? Oh, you were? Okay. You're called on a second time. My bad. That's why we need participation cards. I don't know why it's not so kicking out.
Don't you split it?
You do split into two different problems. Here, let me write the line down for us. Okay, there's my split. Give me one of the problems, Josue. Plus one. 3x plus 2. Those aren't equations yet. You need an equal sign in there, right? That's right. There it is. And again, Josue properly ignored that 4. It's not going to affect us at all. It was just kind of annoying and bothering us at the very beginning. It does affect you when you're graphing by quite a bit. It stretches out the graph top and bottom, like vertically stretched. But for now, it doesn't really matter in terms of our x-intercepts. All right, so from here, now, Chloe, go ahead and answer these.
So you subtract one. I'm looking at the first one. You subtract one on each side, so you get 2x equals negative 1. And so you're left with x equals negative 1/2. And then for the second one, you subtract 2 from each side. You get 3x equals negative 2, which equals x equals, wait, x equals negative 2/3.
There's our two answers. That was an intermediate type of question. Good job, Chloe. Do I have enough room in here? I think I'm going to make this one still an intermediate, but I'm going to show a different type of trick. Is that okay? If you combine these two tricks together where you have to like factor out a GCF and do this other trick, then that's a hard or an advanced level problem. But I'm going to make it kind of easy just so I can squeeze it in here. Example 3. I'm going to make it. Hold on, let me do my brainstorming real quick. Oh, done. All right. Ready, set. X squared plus 3x. I'm going to put a negative x over here on the equal to sign. Minus 30 plus 2 is going to be over there. Let me just double check that this works out. Yeah, that works out. Cool. This is an advanced level problem because look, there's no zero. Where'd the zero go? It's right there. It's hidden in the 30, Mr. Sindel. What? Where's the zero? We don't have a zero. The right side has to be a zero. Otherwise, we cannot use the zero product property. So what do we need to do, Jose?
X equals 2.
No, we got it. We have to have
move
a zero
to
first.
The other side, Mr. Snow. Plus x minus 2 and then on both sides.
Plus x minus 2 will make that side a zero. If I do it to the right side, I do it to the left side. I add x and subtract 2. That is your first step. And that's the only new trick that I need to show you. Everything else kind of is the same. Let's just quickly solve this one so you can see what happens. From there, you get this problem that looks like this. X squared plus...
Four X.
I mean, I don't know. Okay. Siempre toma la signa más grande. La signa del más grande es negativa. And what about the right side? You'll all shout out at the same time. 3, 2, 1. 0. The whole point was we needed all that stuff gone to get 0. And now we can use the zero product property if we have a product, which we don't. So we need a factor. All right, do we need to do an advanced ninja star or a normal ninja star, Haiti?
Let's get a normal one.
Yep. Honestly, an advanced one will still work. If you are in doubt on what one to do, just do a normal one, will always work. But in this case, you only need to do a normal ninja star. What adds up to 4 and multiplies to negative 32 is the question. So this is the add 4, multiply to negative 32. Raise your hand if you think you have it. Anne totally kind of stole our thinking time away last time, so I'm going to give you guys more time to think.
Whoa.
Solomon wants to talk, so what do you think the answer is? What, Solomon, adds to 4 and at the same time multiplies to negative 32? Go through all the factors of 32. Let me help you. 1 and 32, not very helpful.
6 and 6 and 36.
Yeah, that's what I said. Go through all the factors of 32. 2 and 16, nah, not helpful. 3 doesn't go into it.
Oh, it's 12 and... Oh, it's 5.
Oh, it's 7 and something.
8 and 4.
There it is.
8.
Which one of these is positive? Which one is negative?
So it's positive. Positive 6.
Oh, my God. Thank you.
Yes, there it is.
So, then I'm going to factor this thing. Ashley, can you set this up for us? We still got 28, so I'm not worried about that.
I'm very worried about time. You can die in 5 minutes.
Wait, you want me to set up? I can write x plus 8 and then x minus 4.
X plus 8, x plus 4. Excellent. And when you have a basic ninja star, that means that you have linear coefficients with no, or the coefficients are 1 to make it nice and easy. All right. Ripley, set up our 2 problems. We need a problem here and a problem here because there's 2 things set equal to 0, right?
It's x. Is that a x? Oh, equals 0. Then x times 4.
Takes the base x.
And then we solve really quickly. We subtract 8, subtract 8. We add 4, we add 4. We get x is equal to negative 8. Box it. We get x is equal to 4. We box it and we call it a day.
Cool.
I think those are all the tricks that you need on this. Did I give you anything? Yeah. There is one extra trick, but you guys will. Okay, fine. I'll give you a preview. Did you know if you get x minus 3 times x minus 3 is equal to 0, you're not going to have 2 problems. You're only going to have 1 problem because it's the same 2 problems. There's your extra trick. Now you know everything. All right, cool.
Wait, so you just write square?
No, it's not. I mean, you could. That actually does work. But the way I was thinking of this is you say x minus 3 is equal to 0, and x minus 3 is equal to 0. X is equal to 3, or x is equal to 3. So the answer is just x equals 3, right? Which is the equivalent of you doing this. Like, this is what you said, right? So when you said x minus 3, oh, that's just squared is equal to 0, which works because then you could do a square root plus or minus, square root plus or minus. And then gone, 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 and gone. And we're left with x minus 3 is equal to 0, which still gives you the answer of just 3.
Well, they are going crazy.
I'll leave that on the notes. That's like a separate
that sounds super fun. Yeah.
3 problem. All right. That concludes the notes. We'll stop the recording.
So really, they're really having a good time.
They sound like
yeah, pull out your extra credit records. I'm coming around to sign those.
I have a pen to be waiting.
It sounds like they're having a lot better time than we are.
More
okay, I think
stuff.